Okay, so first off, a lot of credit to Navy. Before we get to the game, obviously appreciation for what they do and how hard their job is, what they do with playing football as well. Very well coached team, difficult to beat. Very few negative plays, very few penalties, so they did a great job. As far as for us, that was pretty embarrassing. I feel like there was so much build-up through the game around here with the fans, around the school and energy, and really feel like we let them down. And so we got a lot of work to do, it was obvious today. Obviously, I think the story of the day is the same thing that we've seen in all of our scrimmages, what's been going on, that we're not productive on offense. 326 yards, 5 of 16, on third down, and fourth down, 5 of 15. And you got 8 drives and 5 punts, 2 turnovers, and a fourth down drop. So we got a lot of work to do over there. Probably doesn't seem like it. By no means am I saying we played well on defense, but I did think we played well at times on defense. We didn't give up too many big plays. But again, that's returning one of the worst defenses in the country, that they had last year there at Navy, and arguably, I think it was the second best offense in the country. So, would have thought the score would have been much more competitive in that situation. So, back to the drawing board, a lot of work to do. Continue to try to get these new guys more involved.
Lane, why did you want to continue playing the game despite how long those delays kept getting?
I don't know any other way to do it. I thought we were still going to win. I thought we'd make a 2-point conversion. We'll pick play down there, the tight end's open. To go to a 3-score game and get an onside kick. Still won 12, whatever it was, 12, 13, 14 minutes at that time. So I would never do anything different. I would never walk in the locker room with my players and tell them we did anything different.
Was there a time where you would have wanted to end it, or would have gone all night if that happened?
We were bunkered down. We were staying for a long haul, and that's just how we are. That's how our program is. It's how want our players to think. And you love football. Why wouldn't you want to keep playing? Regardless how long there was off in between. And people bring up, okay, is there issues about player safety? Well, you think back to when we did 2-a-days forever, all right, you practice, a couple hours off, you practice again. That's honestly what it was like to take that delay was so long.
I need to kind of follow up on that. It's obviously there could have been a real plan for 3 hours and 3 different delays. How did your kids pass the time? What did you have talking to them?
We prepared for this and actually kind of had practiced it once. It's too much, but at the same time too, got to re-warm up, go through all those things. So I know the weather and warm ups, all that stuff had nothing to do with this. This was just we played really poorly in all 3 phases, especially in 1.
Lane, what was just feeling going?
I don't know. It just felt normal. It really didn't feel like a big deal. It was just focused on trying to get the players ready to play and coaches ready to handle situations and. Some of the situations we didn't do a great job of today, so I really didn't think about it like that.
What went into the decision to start Daniel Park?
It actually, as we looked at all the scrimmages combined, all the practices, he performed the best in the situations, completion percentage, plays, touchdown, interception ratio, and so on, and he earned it. So we weren't going to sit and say, well, someone else had played better. If you look at film from high school or junior college, or last year here, we told our guys when we got here to get a clean slate and that the best players are going to play by your performance on the practice field.
You look at the stats, 19-30, almost 300 yards, 2 TDs. What did you see from him?
I thought he was all right. I don't think he was our issue. He played great, but he also didn't put us in a position to lose. Especially as you look at the last interception prior to that, really, he was doing all right. It was just too many negative plays and too many of the same things that it's a lesson for our coaches, for our players. If it's going to happen in practice, to me, and maybe I'm old school, this is going to happen in the game. So when the snap says, you guys see your practice, go ahead, it's going to happen in the game. And if you don't make the right read, it's going to happen in the game. So I just don't believe that you show up on game day and all of a sudden things work.
How did you evaluate DeAndre Johnson?
I thought obviously he ran the ball well there in some situations. I still don't think he was 100%. You know, obviously under through the interception, which was like, you know, he ran by him in the post, could have been a big play, so.
Was there something you saw in Navy where you wanted to throw the ball more, and Motor and Buddy had limited carries tonight?
Yeah, really, it is, as you study them, it is a throw-to-beat defense. You know, just look at last year, people, when they got in space, you know, and got balls out and complete and get things running sideways, had really had a lot of success against them, South Florida, full game, La Tech. And so, as you looked at kind of more stagnant and tight stuff, some of the teams, I won't mention them, but didn't have as much success. So, it really was a, they're kind of more built to be physical in the middle. And you know, they got some two really good inside linebackers. And, you know, the speed issue obviously shows up at times, which it did today, you know, on the two big plays.
I know you said you didn't look at it, you know, sort of grand your back first game terms, but did you even allow yourself like a moment to look around before the game and just kind of take in?
No.
Just play some sort
of? No, I really wasn't thinking like that. We got so much stuff to do to try to prepare really well so that we handle every situation. And obviously today, we did not do a great job of that.
Coach, with DeAndre, he kind of had a nice rhythm and a flow when he first came in the third quarter. And, you know, at times when he came in running, but he didn't do a whole lot of passing. Is that your plan to kind of mix up with him and Daniel to run the pass, or is just the philosophy game plan for this game?
No, it really wasn't. You know, he had missed a lot of time. And so timing in a passing game, you know, is affected more when you're out and missing time. And I thought even shows in warm-ups, I didn't think he was 100%. So you can still run a lot easier than the timing that you saw, you know. Interception and throws, you know, there's more time in the passing game than being able to quarterback.
In the first quarter, or first half especially, I think you only handed the ball to running backs four times.
Three.
So
they wasn't real excited about that.
You weren't really?
I felt like Coach Staley.
But that was nice. Was that all calls from the sideline, or were those quarterbacks reading something in the defense and getting out of the run?
Well, that's a good question. Some of those are RPOs, and so they're giving you certain looks. They were definitely loading the box. They were stopping the run, you know, which I don't know that, you know, that's not their normal game plan. They're more of a quarters team, you know, and so I think their thought was probably once they saw the new quarterback that, you know, they were going to blitz him, they were going to stop the run and make him, you know, through there try to beat him with a bunch of new receivers too.
We saw you get animated on the Blueberry touchdown. What was going through your mind?
Well, it was kind of one of those where you knew the coverage before, and so we'd just been off, you know, just a little bit on so many plays. You know, the double pass was there, and some different plays, and so to kind of hit one, that would give us some momentum with the quarterback and everybody feeling good. So it was pretty good too, because it was one of those that obviously beat the coverage they ran versus just one person makes a guy miss and makes a good play.
You also appeared rather frustrated, especially with the final of the fighting delays before you were going for two, and you couldn't even get that play off. What was that like as a coach? I saw you probably with the red, really kind of hands up, like, really?
Oh, yeah. No, it was like we finally had something good happen. You know, we had long touchdown pass, and all of a sudden we had another lightning delay. So, you know, it is what it is. And we're going to go back to work. You know, it's one game. We're 0-1, and we should play a lot better, coach a lot better, so we've got to learn from that.
Was there ever a thought of putting Driscoll in the game?
He was going to go back in. We would have stopped him right there on the last one. He was going to go back in.
Thank you.
Coach, Chris Tooley, he had a very productive fourth quarter with the interception and deflection there. Is that someone that you're going to depend on as a leader for the defense coming
Chris
forward?
Chris has done a good job. I know this is kind of seems weird, since it was 2 o'clock in the morning, whatever it was. But, you know, our guys on defense there then, you know, that was that was pretty neat to see for me, because that's a total easy give up moment, you know, especially after all these delays, everything. You know, our guys are flying around, making plays and jumping around. So, that's a good thing on a night of not many good things.
And did Aziz cement himself as a kind of the guy who you thought he might be, as far as a guy gets the ball, sticks the bats, that kind of stuff?
Yeah, I mean, he looked physical at times in there, made plays. And, you know, it's unfortunate. You know, the long passes in the first half was a signal issue where they didn't have the signal and stuff. And so, I mean, you can't fault the players for that. But, those guys are going to score a lot of points on those people, you know, and a lot of yards, especially if we're not getting a lot of first downs or we're giving back to them. So, like I kind of said, I said this week, this game will not define this team because it's such an abnormal game. And I said, whether we win or lose. So we'll go back to work and get better.
Thank you.
All right, guys. Thanks, good.
That's fine.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to start with a few.